On the 21st of December 2018, Inminds Human Rights Group held a vigil outside the world's largest diamond company, De Beers Jewellers, in London, to highlight the link between diamond jewellery and Israeli war crimes in Palestine.
Most people don't realize that diamonds sold in jewellers worldwide are bankrolling Israel's war machine. Israeli economists Sher Heber testified at the Russell Tribunal in November 2010 that overall the Israeli diamond industry contributes about $1 billion annually to the Israeli military.
In 2017, Israel's net export of diamonds was worth $8 billion, making diamonds Israel's number one industry by far.
The Kimberley process was supposed to prevent the trade in diamonds that fund human rights violations, but the Kimberley process's narrow definition of a conflict diamond excludes cut and polished diamonds.
In October 2015, Shmuel Schnitzer, president of the Israel Diamond Exchange, blocked the Kimberley process, widening the definition of conflict diamond to include countries who flout human rights laws not just in mining areas but also in diamond trading centers, saying it could be disastrous for Israel.
Jewelers exploit this anomaly and deceitfully claim that diamonds crafted in Israel are conflict-free.
In 7 weeks, in 2014, Israel slaughtered 521 Palestinian children whilst they took shelter in UN schools. The Israeli diamond boss boasted of sending truckloads of military equipment to help the slaughter.
An engagement ring is meant to signify love, not death and slaughter. Don't wear a trophy of Israeli butchery on your finger. The children that diamond has helped kill will forever be on your conscience.